So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Clementine knows. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore. Asked me about it. I couldn't lie to her.
What exactly did happen with the senator?
It was an accident. I mean, I pretty much knew about the affair. Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
We work as a group. All of us looking out for each other.
I hear that. There's so many dumbasses out there fighting each other these days. It's just stupid.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Enough to defend ourselves.
Well, that's good. It's getting dangerous out there. Well, you guys know. Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for, well, as long as I can remember, but now it's...
You think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always
fucking
pulling this shit.
Bandits. Who? Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you.
Fucking
you knew we were hungry. And you guys were keeping it
there's
all
only
yourself.
Two.
Oh no, there's
yeah,
a lot
you know what?
More
we ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens. But let's just wait this out and hope they move on.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you!
Jesus!
Asshole.
The world out here has gone to shit. Come on, let's get to the dairy where it's safe. Here it is, St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
Ever have any accidents?
Nah. It's safer here than out there.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting, hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow 'em good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh, my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place. Now that y'all are here, we'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Does that offer apply to the rest of us?
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh my! Our prayers have been answered!
Maybe our whole group could come. For the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'd be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
They're offering us food. We should do whatever we can to make these people like us.
The way Brenda was talking, I get the feeling like she'd be happy to have us stay.
All the more reason for us not to fuck this up. If Andy needs some help securing the perimeter, then that's what we do. Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet. Mind if I fix it?
Sure, that'd be great. Mama sure does appreciate y'all helping out.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat and some rope. Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. John's know we can pull our weight around here. Right now, but if I can find something to cut it down to size, this might make a good seat for the swing. Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
Fence is fantastic. We'll do whatever you want to help keep it running.
Well, clearing that perimeter is going to be a big help. Just let me know when you're ready.
What's that?
Generator. You guys come along with gas just in time. Hey, don't mess with that, okay? The thing's a little tricky, and I don't want to spend half a day trying to fix it again.
So what's your read on Andy so far? Think they'd be open to letting us stay?
Getting the perimeter secured is gonna help us a lot.
We'll be getting in good and making this place safer for us.
I'm gonna get back to it. This rope is perfect for the swing. This dairy won a lot of ribbons in its day, huh?
This place was my daddy's life. Meant everything to him. You know, when he first bought this place, it was a single-story house.
Is that right?
After us kids was born, he insisted on adding a second floor. Said they had to have room for as many babies as they could have. Mama, she was done after Dan.
My folks stopped after two as well.
Then one day, the world changed. Now this place is all we have left of Daddy. That's why we take such good care of it, and why we want to share it with good folks like yourselves.
Fresh herbs. I can hardly wait for dinner.
Well, hi there, Lee. What can I do for you, sweetie?
Can I help you with anything around the house?
I think with Danny's help, I've got things pretty well squared away in the kitchen. But feel free to check with Andy. He's got a lot of weight on his shoulders these days, so I'm sure he'd love any help he can get.
Your family's done an amazing job of keeping this place up.
Well, now aren't you sweet? Thank you, Lee. The boys and I have tried to adapt as best we can, but we still keep some of our old routines to help remind us of better times.
What happened to the rest of your staff?
Oh, we've had our share of tragedy here, just like everyone else, I'm sure. Some of our staff took off to find their family as soon as they heard the news. The few that stuck around, well, we lost most of them the first night those things showed up here. It was a tough night.
How many rooms does this house have?
Rooms? Why do you ask?
It looks custom-built.
Nice of you to notice. My husband put a lot of work into this old house.
Well, he did a fantastic job.
I believe in making a house a home.
Well, if anything comes up that I can help with, feel free to let me know.
Well, Lee, I sure appreciate it.
No problem. All right, this shouldn't be too tough.
Well, I'll be damned. Mama's gonna be thrilled to see that old swing all fixed up.
Hopefully our kids will like it too.
Did you say something, darling? Oh my goodness, did you do that?
Just trying to help out a bit around here.
You know, I used to push Andy and his brother out here on that swing every night when they were kids. Seems like such a long time ago now.
Yeah, it does. All fixed. That should make everyone happy. Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. Been stockpiling, huh?
Yeah, if you need some extra people to protect the dairy, you can count on us.
Well, hopefully it'll never come to that, but thanks.
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots, and we gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick, you know? Like us.
Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but gets overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
Do you think we're doing enough to get the St. John's to like us?
Well, we don't want to seem over-anxious. Showing them we can handle this fence is going to go a long way.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
What's up with you telling him what I said about him thinking I'm dangerous?
Look, you said it. You even admitted it right to him.
That guy's a piece of shit anyway.
Relax. You're not making things any better riling him up. There's one. Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off.
Andy said when this fence is working, the walkers go up like a tree branch on a power line. If those lights are out, that means the fence is off, right?
It better be. Maybe the St. John boys are using this guy for target practice?
Poor guy.
I don't know what got him first, the arrow or the fence. Either way, hope he was already dead. Disgusting.
Who do you think he was?
Maybe a farmhand. I don't know. I hope he wasn't like this long before the fence finished him off.
Yeah.
Come on, I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
Yeah, well, it's useless without gas. We might need food, but the St. John's need gas, too.
Not many drivers these days, Lee. We could scrounge up a year's worth of gas, easy. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. They seem decent enough. I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down. That's all.
Thanks. There's another one.
I see it.
Man, the fence burnt right into its hands. I think they fused together.
You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Would have been nice to get some of those rations. I get hungry too, you know.
We'll go ask for more to eat after this is done.
All right, I can suck it up. Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
Little help here, Lee?
If you're waiting for that guy to help, it ain't gonna happen. Come on.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
What the? Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole!
Jesus!
We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out!
You fuck with us! It will take too long! Give us the food!
Quick! They'll see you!
Don't think I can't see you! What about our arrangements? Did you really think you could fuck with us?
The blades are stuck in the dirt!
Damn! Trying to lure me to the outfit from over there!
Come on, if we can reach the gate, we can get through this fence and back to the house!
Ah!
Shit,
that hurts!
I see you! I see ya! Get closer! You already got one of your...
What happened?
Shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. We're gonna have to move him.
I see you! You asshole!
Do this all day!
You really think you're fucking out of
your
I already got one of you.
Another one? How many of those things did we
you
push
didn't
down?
Deliver the goods. Now we're gonna take what's owed. What about our arrangement?
You okay?
Yeah. Barely.
Come on. The gate's right there.
Let's get out of here.
Behind the tractor! You lucky sons of bitches! Go ahead and run! We ain't going nowhere!
Lee, what's wrong?
There was a goddamn ambush out there!
Holy shit! Are you okay?
The bandits? Here? On our property?
Oh, my lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out. God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my god, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh, no, honey. Come on, Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veteran.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhand.
We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carley said this place was locked down tight.
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carley?
Since Carley and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor inn until we get back.
Hey, kids, look what Lee got working for you.
A swing. I love swings, just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc. Thanks, Lee. You're the best.
Yeah.
They're storing gasoline all over the property. You can definitely tell they built this thing themselves. I guess Mark and I were lucky we weren't touching this thing when it came on. That thing keeps a fence electrified. There's not enough room in the house for all of us. I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts. Lots of hay. Enough of these might work as adequate cover from arrows, if that becomes a problem. Having a crop like that on hand must be great. We're gonna need to learn how to maintain it if we end up staying here.
Lee, oh my God, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything. But gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
Kenny believes there's still hope. Maybe that's what we need right now.
Well, hope doesn't do any good if we're all dead. I'm focused on keeping us alive. and not giving my dad food. That was cold.
Looks like a feeding station for the cow. Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun. Thanks for fixing it.
You're welcome.
Will you push me on it?
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
You're lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Yeah, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
I don't think so.
Oh, Lee?
Yeah?
I miss my family.
I know, Clint. I miss mine, too. Don't worry. We're safe here now.
As long as the bad people don't get me, too, right?
I won't let what happened to Mark happen to you.
Promise?
I promise. All right, Clem, that's enough for now.
Okay, thanks for pushing me.
Of course, it's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck, don't pop a gasket.
Hey.
Hey, Lee. How's it going with the St. John's?
Good. I was talking to Andy earlier and offered our group's assistance on the dairy. I don't think they have much to protect them besides the fence, though he seemed pretty appreciative.
Great. Sounds like they're starting to accept us.
Definitely. I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here?
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
Yeah, of course. Lily's judgment is clouded, but you got a pretty clear head about these things. Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
No, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out, maybe he and Katja can have an easier life here.
That's funny, considering you didn't seem too worried about Duck back at Herschel's farm.
That's in the past, Kenny. A lot's happened since then.
Yeah, right.
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah, but I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. Sounds like they're pretty amped up about it. This might be a good way to earn their trust.
Good idea. They look happy. Fellas?
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy.
Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save-Lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So, are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah, we gotta work together on this. Those bandits are a danger to everybody. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Are you going now?
Yeah, I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.